welcome back to the show. Thank you so much for being here. How are you? How's the fam doing?
Great. We're all great.
Yeah. Are your kids in college?
Two of the three of my children are in college.
Wow.
Yeah.
Like, are you in full deep into the college thing and, like, rooting for the teams and showing up for the games and all that?
Oh, yeah.
That's
It
comes with the territory.
Yes. Like, you become immediately, like, is my entire life.
Yeah. You have to.
I wear the colors. I do the whole thing.
Yeah, you got to show up.
Yeah.
And then who stays home? Who's the youngest that's still at home?
Henry. Ooh. Hi, Henry.
Hi, Henry. And is Henry loving this or kind of missing his?
I think it's a good 50-50 split.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is.
He's loving it. But also, and I think he misses his people.
Yeah. I know you're a tight family. You went to go see Taylor Swift together, and. You actually put on Instagram, you posted, Taylor Swift, I love you. Thank you for being everything we ever needed, ever. Eras Tour, hashtag Betty, hashtag 13.
Hashtag superfan.
Yeah, you're a Swiftie.
Right? Yeah. Yeah.
You're a Swiftie.
Are you not a Swiftie?
I'm such a Swiftie. Oh, my gosh, yeah. Yeah, my kids are into it, but I'm into it, too.
My Spotify Wrapped.
Me too.
It was embarrassing.
Yeah. By the way, it really was.
It was not the, like, cool, oh, let me share this with all my friends. It was like a...
Yeah. Mine was
I
all
figured
that.
As much.
I figured as much, I think I was also in, like, the top 3% of Taylor Swift listeners or something like that. I'm like, wow.
Wow.
It's real. Yeah, I got a problem. I got a problem.
Some talk therapy.
Is Betty your jam? Is that your song?
I love Betty, and my mother's name was Betty, so I particularly love Betty.
Oh.
Yeah.
I have a photo of you with Taylor Swift from 2015.
Yeah.
This is you on stage with Taylor Swift.
Yeah. And...
Is that Joan...
Joan Baez.
Joan Baez?
Yeah. Wait.
What was it? Explain this. What was this?
Okay. I don't even know if this is going to be interesting for television.
Sure. If you say
it,
let's
roll those dice. Okay. No, wait. So we need this. So,
First
of all, I took my kids. This was, like, our first big concert. And... Taylor had said before the show, you know, there's a part in the show where would you like to come up? And I was like, oh, I don't know. I get very nervous. I mean, I'm so sweaty right now. Words cannot describe. And so I was like, oh, I don't know. And at the time, I think Finn and Hazel were 10 and Henry was 8. And they were like, oh, Mom, you should do it. You should do it. And Henry goes, don't do it unless you feel comfortable.
That's my man.
And then I said, well, get a Taylor Swift T-shirt to wear if I go on stage, because I was wearing an outfit that I had worn like 2 days before on the Ellen show.
You can't catch
and
a break.
I didn't want people to be like,
you have
does
one
she
outfit?
Ever change?
Yeah, does she ever change? That's so funny. And so you just came out and just hands up, or what'd you?
The whole thing was pretty surreal. And the Joan Baez part of it made it even more surreal.
I mean, come on.
We kind of look like we're a couple who got married. Right?
It does look like that.
I'm not a flower. And it's like she officiated.
Yeah, it does look like that.
Yeah.
And that was your kid's first concert?
It was kind of our first big, like, trip for a concert. It was pretty major.
Do you remember your first concert?
I do.
Is it cool?
It's so much cooler than my Spotify Wrapped.
What was it?
Cheap Trick.
Ooh, not bad.
Yeah.
Opening band?
I mean, it was kind of a sneak out of the house situation, so I don't know that I got there right on time. It wasn't like I had my ticket and, you know, my mom dropped me off. It was not like
that. Yeah, she's like, you just ran. You're like, oh my gosh.
She thought I was at someone's house studying for a math test.
Oh my God. That is so cool. Come on, that's rock and roll right there.
It was pretty cool.
That's perfect for Julia Roberts. That's kind of perfect. I want to talk about your movie.
Okay.
This is written and directed by Sam Esmail, who I know from Mr. Robot.
Mr. Robot. He created Mr. Robot, and he and I did a TV show together called Homecoming. And yeah, I just think he's a brilliant, hold your applause, he's a brilliant guy.
He's not coming out. Don't give him a standing ovation. He's not coming. No, don't give him a standing ovation. Yeah.
And he adapted this screenplay from a beautiful novel that was... super scary.
It was a giant book.
Yeah, and he called me up and said, "Hey, I've got this book I want you to read."
It's good. It's a great movie. It's creepy. It's an apocalyptic thriller. Leave the world behind, and I don't want to give any spoilers because I don't want to give anything away. But I will bring up something.
Oh.
Well, the One of the things that happens is you and your family are all happy family. By the way, great cast.
Great cast.
Love Ethan Hawke.
Yes.
And so you and Ethan Hawke, you got the family, you're hanging out, you're in this in the middle of the kind of off the beaten path, mm-hmm. in the middle of the woods somewhere, and you get this Airbnb, and then you get a knock at the door.
In the middle of the night.
Middle of the night. You have no Wi-Fi, cell phones are out. Knock on the door. First of all, I wouldn't answer the door. I would hide wherever I could hide.
That would be a short film category.
I'd let the kids open the door. I go, hey, kids, go get the door and see who's there. I don't get it. You kidding me now? But then the guy at the door, and hopefully I'm not spoiling, he goes, oh, hi, I know that everything's out. I actually rented you this Airbnb. This is my house. So do you mind if I stay over the night?
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a problem.
Yeah.
That's a conundrum.
That's a movie.
That's a movie. No, no, no. I'm just short. Yeah. That's a movie. It's really great. And also, President Barack Obama and Michelle Obama are producers on the film.
They are.
I saw that in the beginning.
I
go, wait.
I know.
How did that happen?
I know. It's pretty rad. It's right up there with Cheap Trick as my first concert.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
this is my street cred right there.
And did they work closely with the film?
Yes, you know, they, well, this was on President Obama's reading list. You know, he puts out his cool books and cool songs.
Right.
And so this book was on his list, and he's a big fan of Mr. Robot. And so I think he and Sam, you know, collaborated, with the notes in the beginning and the notes when we were done filming in the post-production. And
was he, well, imagine him in the editing room. Like, now, if he knocked on the door, I would hide. It's his Airbnb. It's his Airbnb. He can do what he wants. He's allowed to live there. It's his house. I want to show a clip. Here's Julia Roberts in Leave the World Behind. Take a look at this.
You think something happened to our satellites, the ones in space?
The satellites are networked to computers down here.
So you think that the hackers or whatever knocked out our satellites.
I no longer think that this is just a couple of teenagers in the Philippines.
Where are my kids?
Julia Roberts, everybody, Leave the World Behind is in select theaters now and on Netflix this Friday. We'll be right back with more Tonight Show. Stick around, everybody.